You know, I'm sitting here this morning just pondering the matter of faith. Where does it come from? How can people have more faith than others? And it brought me back to Mark chapter 4, one of my favorite chapters. Actually, Mark's my favorite book in the whole Bible. I just love it. It's a book of action. Anyway, why do some people have great faith in certain things and other people have very little or none, it seems like? And I was pondering, you know, I just sowed some seed in my backyard. And of course, in Mark chapter 4, the word of God is likened to seed. It's Jesus compares it to seed. And in that parable is the secret. Is the secret to getting answers. It's a secret to living a life that is just amazing. There are four types of soil, but I'm not going to focus on the first three. I'm just going to focus on the one, the good heart. You know, I just sowed seed in my backyard, and the only seed that is going to grow is the seed that the ground in my backyard receives. Is a seed that the ground in my backyard cherishes and envelops. And that ground in my backyard is going to draw out the life of that seed and cause that life in that seed to produce what's in that seed. You know, your heart is so vital. You know, God's word's so powerful, but it's looking for a place. It's looking for a heart that will caress it, that will envelop it, that will ponder it, that will consider it, that will just plain, just receive it and let it soak and settle deep into our heart. And when our heart is in such a state, it releases the power of that seed, and that seed grows. And as we continue to nurture it, it grows and develops into what is within that seed. The promises of God, every one of them are yes. Every one of them contain something that we need. Whatever that need is, you need to find a word. And you need to take that word and you need to let your heart receive it. Let your heart caress it, envelop it, ponder on it, muse on it, dream about it, and I guarantee you that seed will grow and develop and release that promise into your life, into a fully developed, visible promise. That grass out there is invisible, but when the good soil receives it and begins to do what I just described, it's going to grow into a yard. It's going to grow into a lawn that's beautiful and lush. Well, the Word of God works the same way, people. That's why, oh, I believe the Word of God. You know what's sad? There's Christians today that are getting up right now. They never even consider the Word of God. They just let the Word of God sit on their table, on their desks, and their book bags or wherever they put it until next Sunday. And they never know the power of the promise that's in those words of that book. You know, I would beg you, if I could, get into the Word of God. What do you need? What is lacking in your life? What are you crying out to God for? Find a word for it. Ponder on it. Take it in. Let it incubate. Let it grow in your heart. And I guarantee you it'll develop over time as you muse on it. As you ponder it, things will begin to happen. Life, the life of that seed, will respond to the moisture, to the warmth of your heart. And it will begin to produce in you what it says. This is a powerful word. I would challenge you to get into Mark chapter 4. Read the whole chapter. There's a lot of good stuff in there. Think about it. Ponder on it. And I pray to God that You will become a person who meditates on His word until it is alive in you and manifested through you. There's nothing more important than the word. Faith comes from the word. Faith comes from the promise that is totally, that totally engrosses us and causes us to think about it all the time. So it's the way it works, folks. There's no other way. Get your Bible, get into it, love on it, let it take root in you, and you will live a very blessed life and be a blessing to others. God bless you. Have a marvelous day.